Hi, I'm Gaylerd. I hope you've enjoyed what you've learned from the series so far and that you're ready to learn even more. Because now I'm going to show you how to bring the flavor out of the dull, boring way we all learn to strum chords by showing you how to season them with wow factor riffs, fills, and transitions. And in this lesson, I'm going to give you three ideas that you can use as foundations for creating your own exciting riff patterns in A minor. We'll be building those patterns by using a few of the A minor fretboard notes and combining them with accent strumming. The goal is that by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to create and even personalize A minor transitions for any song you play on acoustic guitar. So get your pick, get your guitar, meet me in the studio. I'm going to show you how to have some fun with A minor. Okay, to get started, let me tell you that all three patterns that I'm going to show you are common patterns that I use when I play A minor today. So while you're definitely going to want to learn them to use them to practice with, you need to know that you're not limited to them. In fact, you're going to want to use these as the starting point to get your creative juices flowing. You're going to want to look for ways to change them and to personalize them so that they fit the chords, the tempo, and the beat of the song that you're playing. So here's what we're going to do. Okay, I'll put the tab for each pattern on the screen so you can see the notes as well. Then we'll use that pattern as the transition to make three chord changes. We'll change from the A minor to the G, A minor to E minor, and A minor to D minor. Now I'll use a similar strumming pattern for all three transitions so it doesn't get real confusing for you. And I'll keep it a simple strumming pattern. It'll just be an up and down strumming pattern until we get into the accents, and I'll show you how to throw some really cool accents in there. But a typical everyday guitar player is going to play an A minor to a G with this beat, and here's the strumming pattern we're going to use. And this is what it would sound like average guitar playing. Like that. But here's where I'm going to keep you busy. Each time we change to one of those chords, we're going to use a different method to get back to that A minor. For instance, when we change to the G chord, we're not going to just strum up and down. We're going to put accent strumming into it, and to do that, the first time we do it from a G back to A minor, we're going to throw a D chord in there real quick, just as an accent chord, to make that, just to bring out the flavor, and it'll be like this. Like that. We just throw that little accent in there real quick. So when we go to the E minor, since you already know the E minor fretboard notes, we'll use a few of those notes to transition back to the A minor. That way you'll get practice using transitions for two different chords. And we'll make it a real simple one because this is your first time we're doing this. We'll use the 6, 5, 4, and 3 strings and just kind of do a little walk up like this. Like that, okay? Then when we get to the third chord, the D minor, we're going to use another accent strumming technique of using chords to get back to the A minor. And here's what we'll do. When we get to that D minor, we'll just strum that. Then we'll go E minor, F, G, and back to A minor. So this one would sound like this. Then to close it out, once we get back to that final A minor chord, I want you to think of that little chord walk up like the outro to the song, the very ending of the song. And I'm going to show you a cool way to end on that A minor. So it'd be like this when we go up the fretboard. Something like that. And I'll show it to you. That's just kind of giving you a tease right there. By setting the exercise up like this, you'll get practice using both A minor and E minor riff transitions, accent strumming, quick chord changes, and even ideas for song endings, or outros as they're called. Okay, now let me run through this exercise for you so you can get a look at what I'm talking about. That way it might be a little bit easier for you to look at it than for me trying to explain it to you. And what you'll do after I'm finished with it, you can use this portion to come back and either play with me or just turn the sound down and just play along. But whatever you want to do, that you want to make sure that you're able to make these chord changes and these transitions smoothly before you go on to the next session, okay, or the next lesson. So let me show you what we're going to do. When we change the chords, we'll do those chord changes twice for each chord. So when we go A minor, G minor, A minor, we'll do that twice. A minor, D minor, A minor, we'll do that twice. The same thing with D minor. So here's the strumming pattern that we're going to do with this, with the accents in it. It'll be like this. And what we're going to do to get the accents, we're going to lift those fingers up off the strings. Now, I'm going to lift them up a lot. If you're a beginner and you're struggling with this, you may want to only lift them up once for each chord, but you want to do it at least once to get that accent in there, and you want to try and get as many as you can. So here's, I'm going to play it with all the accents in it. You put the accents where you can, but it'd be like this. Like that, okay? Okay, but the way we're going to throw that transition in is you'll only play the A minor one beat. On the second beat of the A minor, you're going to go in and throw in that transition. So it'd be like this. That's the way we'll do for each one of those transitions. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and play through this whole exercise for you one time at 100 beats per minute. I'll turn the metronome at 100 beats per minute. Now, if you're a beginner and this is fast for you, then you may want to turn it down. If you're an advanced player, then I'd turn it up to 120 because that's really where you want to be at. But I'm doing 100 because that's kind of in the middle for everybody right now. And so we'll do it at 100 for the practice. And once I'm done with it, you'll stop the video and go back and play along with me to make sure that you're able to keep up at that pace. And then once you're doing it with me, you can change to any chord that you want to, but make sure that you're able to make these transitions nice and smooth before you go on to the next lesson, okay? Okay, so I'll go ahead and put the metronome on at 100 beats per minute and go through the whole exercise for you, then come back and play it with me and keep practicing this until you get it down nice and smooth. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so here's the second transition, and it's basically a walk down from the A minor. And there's the tab on the screen, and it basically goes like this. And then from that point, you'll change your chord, okay? Now, I would like you to try and use your index finger. That's the one that's on that second string for the A minor anyway, right? So you're going to go, use your ring finger for the second fret on third, middle finger for your fourth string, and then your ring finger again for third on five, middle finger two on five, and then you'll make your chord change. Okay? So let me go ahead and play this one through for you all the way. We'll do the same thing as you did with the first transition. When I'm done with it, and we'll be at 100 beats per minute, stop the video, practice this transition, and make sure you're able to do it nice and smooth before you move on. Okay, so here we go at 100 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so here's your third transition, and this one's a little bit trickier. You're going to use your pinky to do a pull-off. While you're in that A minor formation, you're going to use your pinky to do a pull-off on that first string, third fret first string. And then you're in that formation, A minor formation, you want to do. So the whole thing would be like this. And then you make your chord change, okay? So let me play this through for you at 100 beats per minute, and then you'll practice that and make sure you're able to do all three of these before you move on to the next video. And then I'll see you in the next video. 1, 2, 3, 4.